3D elements in motion graphics and graphic design is a trendy topic these days because of the visual interest. In today's video, we're going to create this kind of 3D animation or 3D motion graphics by using PixCap. PixCap is an online 3D platform that you can use to create 3D animations and assets for graphics design, motion graphics, video games, web design, and social media. It has so many ready-made 3D templates and assets which you can edit according to you. You can change the colors, camera perspective, lights, shadow, character poses, and export them as an image or video. And the best thing is, it is very easy to use. You only need a web browser with a stable internet connection to access the PixCap from anywhere in the world. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's jump into it and get started. Alright, so we need a good web browser such as Google Chrome, Safari, Firefox to open this website. So I'm using Google Chrome. Let's search for PixCap over here. Or you can also click on the link in the description of this video and open the website. So this is the PixCap website, and obviously we need a good internet connection to run this website smoothly. I have already logged in into the website, and this is my account. You can manage your account from here. And here we have so many different type of 3D elements or 3D assets. I think 50 to 60% of the elements are absolutely free over here. But we have some pro elements as well. So these are the pro elements that have a pro icon on it. So if you want to use these pro elements, you have to upgrade your free account into pro account. And if you want to upgrade your account, just go to the link in the description of this video and just use the promo code SM20 and get 20% discount. And we have some pre-made scenes as well. So this is the scene section. Just go to the scene section, and here we have pre-made scenes right over here. So we have so many different type of scenes. As you can see, we have animated scenes. So if you want to use this scene, just open it up, and we have the animation as well, just like that. It's looking very nice. You can export the design by clicking on this button. You can export the scene in PNG format or maybe JPEG, or you can also export as a video format from here. So it's very simple. Now let me show you how you can create a scene by yourself. So it's very simple. You only have to click on the My Project, and here you have to create a project. So click on the Create a Project, and this is the editor. If you want to use this as a software, you only have to click on F11 on the Google Chrome to full screen. Now it's looking like a software, but you don't have to install any software. You can use directly into your browser just like that. Now let me create a scene. So it's very simple. Let's add a ramp over here first. So click on the add button, add a cylinder from here. To use this website, you only need some basic information about a 3D software, such as how to rotate this viewport. So it's very simple. Hold Alt on the keyboard, hold left mouse button, and rotate the viewport just like that. If you want to zoom in, you only have to hold Alt on the keyboard, hold right mouse button, and drag your mouse to zoom in and zoom out smoothly. Or you can also use the scroll up and down button. Or if you want to pan the grid, you only have to hold the middle mouse button and drag left, right, top, bottom, whatever you want. So it's very simple to use. And now I'm gonna create a basic foundation. So it's very simple. Right now we have the move tool active. So I want to increase the scale, so hit R to active the scale tool. Just hold down the middle button and drag to increase the size of this, just like that. And I want to keep it like this, so just use the green point and create a shape something like this. Now you can move the shape over here on the grid. You can increase the scale a little bit more. You can increase the smoothness from here, just like that. Now it's looking perfect. I want to add water on it because I want to create a beach kind of scene. So just add the water over here. So if you click on the add button, we don't have any water option, so you can use the library. So click on the library, search for water. So these are the water elements. I'm gonna use the round sea water element. Just click on that, and here we will get the water scene. Just keep it like this. I want to downsize and fit this water on the shape, just like that. Perfect. Now I want to add the ground over here, so let's create a duplicate of this shape. So here we have the cylinder which we have created. Just select the cylinder, right click on that, click on copy, and you can hit Ctrl V to paste. Perfect. Hit R to open the scale, and let's down the size a bit and set it like this. Hit W on the keyboard to active the move tool and just place it over here. Perfect. Now we have to add some assets and create a complete scene. So it's very simple. Just go to the library. I want to add a tree on it. So search for tree. And these are the tree elements. You can use any tree elements on it. So I'm gonna use the palm tree. So click on that. And here we have the palm tree, placed it over here. You can increase the size of the tree like this. You can rotate the tree as well, so hit E on the keyboard, and you can rotate in any axis according to you. Hit W, active the move tool, and placed it over here. Now I want to add a chair and umbrella over here. So again, just go to library, search for umbrella. Now I'm gonna use this pro element, which is the umbrella and the chair. So let's use the beach umbrella. Perfect. Now you can increase the size and fit this element over here. Alright, you can customize these things, maybe the color. So if you want to change the color, you can simply double click on that, and here we have the umbrella color. You can click on the three dot button, and here we have the edit. Let's select the red color for now. Perfect. You can select the red color, and we have this type of red color umbrella. Now I'm gonna use the same method and add so many different type of assets and create a complete scene. So I'm gonna do this in fast forward. So we have a good looking scene, as you can see. Now let's create a ramp for this. So it's very simple. Just click on the add button, and here we have the curve plane. Add a curve plane, hit R to open the scale, and let's scale it up very big, I think, and just placed it over here maybe. So you can increase this width value just like that. So basically we have a backdrop here. Now you can change the backdrop color. So click on the base color. Now you can change this to yellow maybe. Perfect. All right, and then we have to create the camera. So click on the add button, add a camera. Select the new camera that you have created right now. And this is the camera. Now you can see through the camera. So you can set the perspective whatever you want. Perfect. So now we have the camera. Now you can go to the perspective camera. Now you can customize this color. So it's very simple. You only have to double click on that color. And here we have the base color. You can change the base color from here. So you can select the yellow or maybe green, pink, whatever you want. Or you can just keep it the previous color like this. So it is very easy to change the color. And now let me show you how you can animate these things. So let's create the group of these things. So select these things. Just keep the directional light outside of the group. And one more thing, we have to keep the curve plane and the camera outside of the group and right click on that, click on group nodes. Now you can minimize the group. Perfect. And select the group. Let's create a rotation. So just open the graph editor from here. Just go to very first frame, maybe on 0, and we have turned on the auto key. Hit E on the keyboard to rotation, and you can set the rotation over here and just go to the end of this. You can rotate the complete scene just like that. And now we have the rotation animation. You can set the frame rate. So I want to keep this 30 frames per second, and you can set the start and end. So I'm going to set the 120, which is the 4 second, or 150, maybe 5 second, according to 30 frames per second. And now we have the complete animation, and you can change the color contrast or something. So just deselect everything, and here we have some options. So this is the light option. You can change the light color, or you can use the environment map as well. You can change the intensity, and here we have the glow effect. You can turn on the glow effect. This is the tone mapping, so you can turn on the tone, and you can change the exposure or contrast. Maybe I'm gonna use the contrast like this, and exposure maybe down a bit. Perfect. Now we have the vintage, so you can add the vintage or color balance as well. So open the color balance, turn on the color balance, and you can adjust the shadow, mid-tone and highlight tone according to you, but we don't need to adjust this. So we have lots of options here. Now we have to export these things. So just go to the main camera that you have created, and let's take a look first. Perfect. Now I want to export the complete scene. So it's very simple. Just go to export, and here I want to create this thing as a video format. So click on the video and select the size. I'm gonna use this 1920 by 1080. Select the width and height manually from here, 1920 by 1080, mp4 format, and click on export video. Now it is rendering, and now the video is downloaded here. Just click on that, and this is our video, which is looking nice. Overall, this is very useful website. So click on the link in the description of this video and use the code SM20 to get 20% discount. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.